Heyo there, ladies and gentlemen. It's Vela, and I would like to welcome you back to Darksiders. Last episode, we ended up facing against the Griever for the first time, but it seemed like no matter what we did, we didn't ever pierce her armor, its armor, whatever it is, how dare I assume their gender. But last time, we ended up turning off the water pressure, I guess it was, and now we can freely traverse it. Oh shit, there's demon eels. Also, we went down a little trip with Memory Lane and talked about my Beyblade experience as a kid. It also raised a good point of my childhood, and it's me and my brother have been ever since the day we started getting into gamings and competitiveness with each other, we've always been very opposite. It's so weird how we've just been the complete yin to the yang and so on and so forth. Because of the fact that... I already came this way. I'm stupid. Because of the fact... Let's take Pokemon, for example. Every version of Pokemon, we've chosen the opposite one. The only version that he almost chose that was the same as me was... Diamond version, because he was thinking, oh, I don't like pearls, I like diamonds. Hey, we got Reaper. The enchantments boost the harvest of souls from slain enemies. Ooh, that sounds good for the scythe. Let's put down the scythe. Just because, you know, it's very fitting. Scythe, reap souls, so on and so forth. Anyways, until I showed him the legendary Pokemon at the front, he's like, oh man, that's actually really cool. So it's uncanny how much we just compliment one another in terms of our general enjoyment and our bias towards certain things. He's a Blastoise fan. I'm a Charizard fan. He likes Lugia. I like Ho-Oh. We always get into arguments about it too, because it's like, oh, Lugia controls the seven legendary birds. It's like, yeah, but Ho-Oh can come back from the death and bring back things back from the death. And so it's just constantly bickering about whose is better. Sadly, because of the fact that we've grown older and he started to separate away from video gaming, there's not been a lot of bickering and competitive coming from us. But, well, you know, those are still precious memories that I hold close. And that's just one small example. There are many, many, many more from our years as children. Anyways, we've now got our next special little trinket. We've got a glove to complement our large glove. Both of our hands are now massive. Yeah, Tremor Gauntlet. Now we can break the ice crystals or the whatever they are. Battleworn Gauntlet to release a Tremor Wave when charged. To charge, hold Y. So, yeah, that's nice. Oh, shit. That doesn't look friendly. You do not look friendly. Just get out of my way, please. Ooh. Okay, good. You're slow, at least. No, I'm not even done killing him yet. Don't send in reinforcements. Oh, God, it's got the poser. Oh, shit. Ooh, 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 ooh. Hit him. Hit someone. Yes. You can actually control this thing for a little bit. Kill him. Kill him. Ride it. Yes. Hit the poser. There we go. Decapitation is a must. Whew. Get over here. No, I'm not Scorpion, but, you know. I'm allowed to use that quote whenever I want. It's not owned. At least I don't think it is. Is Get Over Here on? Because I know, I haven't played Mortal Kombat since, well, my favorite one, Mortal Kombat Deception for the PS2. And if you know what game I'm talking about, please agree with me. That's probably the biggest mind fudge ever. Just the end of the game, that game's amazing. But anyways, I know that they have a bias towards Scorpion. I mean, he's on their cover of their company logo. So they might have Get Over Here copyrighted, knowing that nowadays you can copyright everything. You can copyright words all the way to You could probably copyright a color. Which, if they, you can, God help us all. God help us all. But you know who God won't help? These guys. Because I'm going to destroy them. Just die, please. Thank you. No, I want you dead. He still didn't die. He's at the animation point to death. Get you over here. Spin blade. And now that should be you. Oh, wow. We had a small pause there for some reason. I don't know what that was. Anyways, now the crystal's broken. Or not broken, but we can break it. We're going to grab some health, too. Oh, yeah. I have the power. War smash. Open this. Hey, another beholder's key. I wonder if it goes to that one right there. Probably does. And I need to learn to use my stone skin more. I actually need to set up stone skin. Because that might help me out a lot here. Especially since everything's doing a lot more damage. I could have swore I set it up before unless I died in there. Then it reset it. I can't completely recall. Ground slam! Submerge. And what's down here? Nothing. A whole bunch of nothing. Although it does have a lot of, like, I don't know if it's called, not, it's not beautiful by any means, but it's kind of interesting coral activity. I guess that's coral. Illuminated glowing coral. Hey game, thanks for telling me where to go. I wouldn't have figured it out without you. God bless you, game. I sort of remember this puzzle. Let me see if I can recall what's up here. Should be... yes, it's you. So now... yep, shockwave punch. Basically, grab it. Punch it. It goes onto there. We now turn the crank. Ascend upwards to this one. Drag you all the way over here. And we're just basically going to be punching this thing from one extended platform to the next. Pretty much, anyway. Whoa, careful. You can't push it off the edge. There we go. Over here. My first time playing this game, I did not know how this puzzle was done at all. Like, I did not comprehend, oh, you could just keep punching it across. No, I was being a moron, and I was thinking, I don't know what to do. What am I missing? And I think this descends. Ooh, there's a artifact over there. Yep, descends. Go get you while we're here. Another soldier. Volgrim's going to be very happy to receive these. Can we get back over? We should. Yes. Beautiful. And punch. No! Oh man, I didn't jump. I didn't jump for some reason. No. Great. Well, that's going to set me back just a little bit. I can't ever get through this section, can I, game, without just having something work against me. It's just fated. The Griever's Lair is one of my most hated areas in the entire game. I guess I shouldn't say hated. One of my most ill-fortuned. It's a better term to use. I don't like the Griever. But I do like how they're using... and some people could say that it's stealing names and so on. But these are names from history and so on and so forth. The names of the bosses. Like, Tiamat. Whenever I hear Tiamat, I don't think of a winged bat beast. I think, since I'm a Dungeon & Dragon player, I think Tiamat, Queen of Dragons. Or Queen of Chromatics. Whenever I hear Griever, I don't think of a spider with a jewel in its crotch. I think Final Fantasy VIII's Griever. And I love Final Fantasy. I don't really like Final Fantasy VIII a lot. The only reason I remember it very fondly is because... once more, as I stated with me and my brother in our competition, I liked Final Fantasy VII. He didn't like VII. He liked VIII. So, I never had the chance to play VIII, but I got to see the entire story play out because I just watched him. And as I went, can you please stop freezing on me, game? I don't know why it's doing that. I may have to reset after this episode. But for some reason, I don't know why, I just never really found a place with VIII. I think it's because the draw system. I don't like the draw system too much. It just feels very repetitive. Because you start out at the first area and you... Holy shit. Stop. 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 I call down the might of the horn to stop you. Anyways, the draw system kind of feels... Okay, Griever. That's nice. The draw system kind of feels a bit out... Not outdated, but... Very long and tedious, because you'd focus on the first area where you draw 99 ice and 99 fire and 99 thunder, and then you go to the next area of the game within the first disc, and then now they got Fire-a and Blizzard-a and Thunder-a, and it's like, well, if I don't draw this, my stats are going to be garbage coming up. However, I will say this about 8, and the final boss...
Played you again.
Oh, shit.
First you don't succeed, I guess.
Yeah, we don't need to hear you. Anyways, I will say this about Final Fantasy VIII. With most Final Fantasy bosses, or final bosses, it does not feel... Since I'm the kind of guy that does not mind grinding, it feels like you can just outscale them and outlevel them by the end of the game really hard, and they're not even too much of a threat. Like Sephiroth, for example. If you get the x4 cup materia, I'm sorry to brag about this, but... I like to do this playthrough with Cloud. I know I'm getting a little bit off topic. I like to do this playthrough with Cloud where I go to the junkyard where you, or the blown up Mako reactor in Gungaga. First, let's blow this up. And keep farming the morph, or keep farming the like Triceratops wheel dudes and turning them into morphs. Get the power sources from them. Buff up Cloud's strength to max. Equipped the Buster Sword onto him and just beat the game like that. And with the x4 cup materia, that pretty much destroys Bizarro Sephiroth. Not Bizarro Sephiroth, but Safer Sephiroth. However, Ultimisha, like, goodness gracious, and I know it's probably spoilers. Yeah. These games are old. These are old games. They go past the spoiler, in my opinion. But anyways, Ultimisha, from what I've seen, no amount of grinding will save you there, because she is strong as all holy hell. Just destructive in my eyes. And it's very refreshing to see that. Let's see here. There's supposed to be another thing to do over here. And... Goodness. Let's just double check what's up here. I know this is the wrong way. I'm 90% sure this is wrong, but let's just check. Nope, yep, that's wrong. Okay. That is completely wrong. I was right. You can't even make it up there. Bless you. Now we need to transition and switch it over. There we go. Which means we gotta go all the way up here and pull the crank. Also, we got the map. I was tunnel visioned, or tunnel mindset, I guess you could call it, on that. No! I messed up again. I have to push this thing off. No, I don't have to push this thing off yet. Okay. This is the one area where it's like, this is the one puzzle where it's like, am I doing the right thing? I don't think I am. Let me double check. Is this the way up? Okay, that's the way back to the top. So we don't want that. We want this to come over here. And if I'm wrong, then I'm just going to skip forward and, you know, make a jump cut to me doing the correct puzzle pieces. But yeah. Oh shit! I overshot it. Come here. Yep. Back over here. Drag it out. You do not fit into that hole. That is not your hole to fit into. Train thing. Come on. Come on. There you go. Alright. There we are. Now we can do this again. Oh man, I took the long way. Sorry. Unnecessary, like, 3 seconds of walking. There we go. Now we can push it over to those, like, fungal walls things. Alright, I think I did it right. I think. Which we know, it's not my strong suit, but I try. Punch it! Aha! It was right! Yay! I'm smart! I did a smarticle! Ba-da-dun-dun-dun! Okay. Get up. Send up you. Because if we had done it to the other one, we just would have ended up on the higher level where you ride on the ropes and you use the bomb from last episode to blow up the red crystal. So this is the correct path. However, we need to remember up top there's more stuff to get. What's this over here? Oh, this leads back to the beginning, I think. Yeah, that leads back to the beginning. Alright. What's about this right here? Okay, yep, that just leads to the other side of the top. It all goes back around. Now, if I am correct, when we get back over here, we're going to have some guests waiting for us. Go over here. Because I think we have guests waiting for us. Over here. And they should be behind this door. Where are we at? Yes, we do! I affectionately like to refer to these as the undead bridesmaids. I don't know why. They just look like they're in bridesmaids' gown. And they're one of the few enemies that actually talk. Well, they don't talk much anymore. Because, you know, she's about to be dead. Ah! Right in half. We'll make sure you fit into that size -0. Haha, lady do. So, too strong to live. But the reason I'm going to live is because I'm stronger than you. Come here and stop. Stop running away. You. Yes, I killed the lady. There's nothing you can do. Okay. Is there any more? Yes, there is. And I think there's another one. I don't want to dance. I'm not good at it. I have 2 left feet. And 10 toes. Total. I don't know what I'm saying. Just stop running away, please. It's not that bad, I promise. I promise you, it's not going to be that bad, dear. Oh, shit. He countered out my flips all with his. What a cheater. We're going to kill you by the foot blade. There we go. Beautiful. Alright. We are going to go back and grab this health. And we'll be all fine and patched up. And I also think this is a good place to end this episode. Next time, if I am correct, we will be facing off against the Griever and taking on the second of the 4 chosen ones that Samael needs the hearts to. We will be hopefully giving the heart to Samael and moving onwards to our next location. So, I hope you're all looking forward to that. I also hope you all have a wonderful day. And a great evening. This has been Valen. See ya.